ここからですね、お待ちかねのテンセットのプロジェクトに関する、ご質問をしていきたいと思います。まず、テンセットの一番のこう、ね、メインの、構想として ETF2.0 という、テーマがあるんですけども、この ETF2.0 が実現した未来は、ユーザーですね、消費者の方々はどのような体験をするのか、具体的な、イメージがあればぜひ教えてください。
They're gonna experience magic. magic of the ETF 2.0. Guys, generally the main idea of the ETF 2.0 is to hold and live from the passive incomes which you can generate just for staking on your private wallet. And this is what I want to focus in and educate people to do it. And we want to obviously, this is going to be just a sneak peek because I cannot tell you the future plans, but what we want to do, we want to improve this part. We want to educate people to hold the ETFs and live from the passive incomes. And very, very soon, probably in the next few weeks, we're going to bring a huge upgrade into our platform. It's going to be tremendous.
Blow my
mind. Yeah. A game changer. And we truly believe that it's going to make a lot of people real diamond hands, a lot of new diamond hands gonna be here. To tell you what the ETF 2.0 bring to you, you need to wait till end of the roadmap. We need to give us a little bit more time. We need to bring everything on the table. We need to strengthen our portfolio. We need to really improve the portfolio, bring the another project, generate the new profits, and we gonna bring all of this with the next gems, especially the next one. Guys, the next gem is like a game changer for all of us, not only for the Tencent, but from the next gems in our platform, also for the Meta Hero, as Robert mentioned on his Twitter. Yeah. But what we need, it's time. Remember, we need time because everything is the process.
ありがとうございます。この ETF2.0 の構想なんですけども、この構想が素晴らしいほど他社さんも取り入れてくると思うんですね。全然別のプロジェクトもそうやってこう ETF2.0 のライバルが、出てきたときにテンセットの優位性があれば教えてください。
はい、 Okay, maybe I'll explain it in the, on the facts. I think 2 weeks ago we presented the article that the Goldman Sachs want to create ETF,
new generation of
some kind of ETF 2.0, because but they named it in the other words. And let's look at some facts. If some kind of giant like Goldman Sachs would create own ETF, it won't be it will be only designed for individual peoples, yes? And Tencent is for mass adoption. Tencent is for everybody. You don't have to register on some site. You don't have to do KYC. Tencent is for the mass adoption. This is the general goal, to bring the cryptocurrencies to everybody, to change the financial situation of many people and let them live from the passive income. Yes, and we are working to develop this part. So we believe Tencent was the first, and the first will be always the winner, like a Bitcoin. Yes, Bitcoin is the king because this is the first cryptocurrency. And guys, our mission haven't changed from the start. We are going straight and we will continue.
We have distinct advantage over some big tech giants or some big companies, and it's flexibility. We can really move fast. We can design our solutions very fast. We don't rely on boards of investors and just people telling us what to do. If you want to try some new idea, we can do it. And that's why we started first, and we are fast. And we have so many ideas how to move forward and where we want to see ourselves in a year, in 2 years. That it's going to be really difficult to catch up, even for giants like Goldman Sachs, because of this lack of flexibility.
ありがとうございます。 では、次は日本のマーケットの、ご質問なんですけども、テンセットは、日本で盛り上がってます、世界と日本のマーケットを比べたとき何かこう違いを感じることがあればぜひ教えてください。
Yeah, of course we can sense that Japanese community is passionate. Yes, we can feel not only the passion to the Tencent, but I think we can clearly say to the cryptocurrencies, and this is amazing because we can't sense this in the Europe exactly. Such a huge how to say it.
But I think it's also because of the cultural differences, because we've got several groups. We've got Turkish, Spanish, English, Korean, Polish. Yeah, we've got a lot of official and unofficial groups, and I have to tell you that every group behaves different. And I think it's also like a cultural difference. But I'm gonna be honest, the most of my private, even the private time, I'm spending in the line with the Japanese community, because that's what Mike mentioned. I think that they are the most involved into the crypto. That's my feelings about the Japanese.
But to be honest with you, international group is also amazing. We have for this moment 8 moderators, and every of these moderators came from the different countries.
Yes.
Rafa came from Spain, Junus came from Turkey, we have Grudy from Germany, we have Dan from the Ireland, so we have multicultural a team.
We have Melissa from Albania.
Melissa, and all of them are
from Denmark.
Yeah, Paul from Denmark, we are from Poland, so guys, and every of them can add a new thing to the Tencent. That's why I think I can definitely say that together we are so strong.
Yes.
Okay. That's the point.
That's what's actually so amazing about the, like for me, for working here at Tencent, I love the feeling that it's so like multicultural, international, and it's just we are like kind of bringing everybody together and share what we, who we are, and how we are a little bit different, but also the same in so many ways, and just learn from each other and grow together. This is really what makes the Tencent amazing, in my opinion. This is why I love it so much.
ありがとうございます。次は法規制についての質問なんですけれども、直近だと海外の大手取引所バイナンスが、法規制の法規制にさらされて事業が縮小するような傾向がありますけれども、テンセットこのプロジェクトも、同様にこう法規制にさらされる可能性ということは考えているでしょうか。
ああ。
So maybe I'm gonna answer as a CEO. First of all, you cannot compare Binance into the any token because this is the exchange. It's got like a totally different regulations. And as Michael said, in the Tencent, you've got this flexibility. Like we can change direction in every moment. Binance cannot do it because it's like, it's a monster. Hundreds of people. Yeah, so it's very hard to change direction. Here, if something happened, what we're gonna do, we're gonna change the jurisdiction, we're gonna change the country, I'm gonna change the office, and I will go into the friendly crypto country. That's it. that's what we did, actually. We are currently in the Albania, where we've got like great regulations. If anything changed, we're gonna go into the different country. It's not a problem. No. So definitely I'm not afraid of that. If something happened in the future, but I'm talking about the worldwide situation, it's gonna affect everybody, not only the Tencent. It's gonna be everybody. But we're gonna face the new situation, and it's not the problem. What you have to do is just solve the problem.
And it's also it's not that like some regulations come unexpectedly. You can always prepare to certain things and adapt before things happen. So we are really not afraid. We are actually like looking forward to some new challenges. And we
ありがとうございます。では、最後の、用意した質問ですけれども、テンセットは、新しいブロックチェーンプロジェクトを支援する、プラットフォームも、構想としてあると思いますが、プロジェクトを支援する基準として、どのような項目があるのか教えてください。
So I'm telling no to the 95% of the projects. That's we've got super high standard to bring anybody into the Tencent Gemlatch platform. And the biggest requirement is that we are not looking exactly for the super initial startups. We are looking for the big companies with the transparency, with the experienced team, with the definitely we are not looking for the project which they need a lot of money for the beginning. We've got a lot of requirements, but the most important for me is personal meeting with the CEOs. And I need to be sure that this new gem, the new company, will work for the next several years. This is the most important for me, because I truly believe that the price can go up and down of the token. It doesn't matter. But if you continue your work, if you continue improvement of your project, sooner or later the price will follow. But you cannot stop. So this is the biggest requirement here is like, I need to be 100% sure. Okay, 99, I can't be 100% sure. 99% sure that this project will develop in the several years. That's what I'm gonna bring.
ありがとうございます。あの最後に、日本の投資家、日本の起業家に向けてメッセージがあれば、一言コメントいただけると嬉しいです。
はい。
Stay strong, diamond hands.
Diamond hands forever. You're not gonna regret it.
Okay, guys, so this is the last sneak peek for us. Diamond hands will be the winners, definitely.
Yeah, the paper hands.Don't worry, paper hands, all weekends, I'm gonna buy you back.
Just slap you with the
buyback. I'm gonna buy you and I'm gonna burn you. It's no problem.
Yeah.
Okay.
Guys, okay. Just to sum up, I believe the new future in Tencent will bring a lot of updates and upgrades. I can show you, but here in front of me, we have three stands. Or tables full of upcoming upgrades. So we will improve Tencent by one. So just give us some time, be patient, and I promise one more time, Diamond Hands will be the winners.
ありがとうございました。
ありがとうございます。
はい、貴重なお時間をいただきましてありがとうございました。また
Thank you guys for your time.
またこのような機会があればぜひご参加よろしくお願いします。
OK, so and thank you very much.
It's a pleasure, guys. Always with you. Bye bye.
And thanks for the support, Japanese community. We love you and you're gonna see our amazing products in upcoming months. Thank you.